As the sun rises and the sun sets on the planet Earth, life goes on for the average person. It doesn't matter where we live at, it's all the same. If we could take a step back and look at Earth from the heavens, we would see that it's on fire. It's in a self-destruction mode, and we choose to ignore it. The writing's on the wall, it's obvious if you just know what you're looking at. There's a one world being orchestrated right now behind the scenes, and the joke's on the average person. The world that we're passing on to our children is a paperless society. They won't ever have the right to have fact-checked information because everything they know is digital. It's on a screen. They've outlawed books before. You don't think they'll do it again? You'd be prosecuted even if you had the Bible back in the days. We're passing on a world to our children where it's a cashless society. They don't understand the difference between a hard and soft currency. They just know that there's some digits on a computer screen and that's how much they're worth. That's nothing, because all they have to press is zero and you don't have nothing. It's really important that you know that a tangible asset, a silver or gold, it brings you more wealth. But the world that we're passing on to our children, they're never gonna know a time when the NSA wasn't spying on them. Our children are never gonna know a time when they always have to relinquish their liberties for a false sense of security. See, we could choose to ignore all the obvious, all the writings on the wall, but eventually, the piper needs to be paid. That's why I have to pay attention to what's going on. That's why I have to do something that I know it's my duty, that I should be doing and standing for something, not necessarily doing what I want to do. I coached soccer for 12 years and I gave that up to do the videos. I changed my life because I know this is what I should be doing. If we could change the hearts and the minds of one person, one at a time, we can make a difference. That's what I realized. See, the information that I'm trying to share with people, people don't want to hear it. And for 7 years, I tried to talk to people, but nobody really listened. But I realize there's a lot of people, millions of people all around this world that believe in God. And they believe in His message. And if I could tell them and get them to understand that there is a Creator, they'll see the noble deed that I'm trying to do is trying to get the people back to their knowledge of understanding that there is a God and we left His side, He didn't leave us, and to repent for our sin and accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. And at the same time, of understanding what's going on in the world, well, they'll listen to me here, but if I give them this information and I put it all together, more people are gonna pay attention. Because the knowledge that I try to share with you guys of what's going on in the news, people don't wanna hear it. But if I talk to their people about their faith in God again, people will listen. So I guess that's why somebody like Patrick Henry said, is life so dear and peace so sweet to be purchased by the price of chains and slavery? Forbid it, Almighty God. You just have to check the facts. You gotta look within yourself and figure out who you are as an individual, man or woman, and what do you stand for? Because there's a lot of stuff that's going on in this world today that the media is not gonna point out or really explain to us. Agenda 21, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, the mutually assured economic global collapse of the world. And it's all being orchestrated right now in our lifetimes. We're all gonna be judged on how we conduct ourselves on the earth. Are you ready to die? Are you ready to meet your Creator? I am. So if you're not gonna do everything in your power to restore your life, liberty, and this country, you're gonna do everything in your power to destroy all three. Charlie the Box, the Patriotic Miscreant, and I'm out.